What up, YouTube? Big Lou with Big Lou East Coast Review. Today, I'm here to have a quick little do-it-yourselfer, you know, something anybody can invest $6 to $8 or maybe $10 in and create something that's real beneficial for them and their vaping, okay? Now, if in the event of the future, the FDA decides to destroy all vaping that we know it and blah, 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 and this and that, and people out there, oh, you know, I always wanted to buy this, I always wanted to buy that. I'm not saying you have to stockpile, but I think it's time that we use our creative perspectives and our minds, because now that we're vaping, we're more open-minded. You know, I believe I'm way more open-minded and more interested in creating things and starting from nothing and creating something bigger. I mean, I've got a different perspective on life. Ever since I started vaping, it has changed my life, just as it's changed a lot of your lives. We don't smell like cigarettes. We don't stink. Our cars don't smell. Our houses don't smell. Our clothes don't smell. I could breathe. Seriously, I was never able to take a deep breath. I was always like that. Now I'm like, I can take a deep breath. I feel great. Okay, this is not a testimony on what vaping has done, but this is only a retrospect of what vaping has now created in my life. Now, yeah, I walk around with a mod 90% of the day, okay, and whether it be a Hexone Box mod, or it's a King version 2, or the Poseidon RDA, or if I'm walking around with a quad coil, a dual coil, single coil, vertical coils, whatever, you know. As we progress in vaping, I like to believe it becomes some sort of like a hobby. So when you're into something that's like a hobby, it simply becomes something where we become more creative. And that is my strongest belief. You know, I started from vaping juice to making juice. I started from vaping pen-looking e-cigarettes to building RDAs. Then from building RDAs, I says, there's got to be some more I can do. Therefore, I decided it was time that I create my own jig. This is my coil jig. I just finished it today, okay? And I've already practiced a bunch of coils on it, and I like it, okay? Now, for those of you who don't know, this is a piece of wood. It's a piece of cedar, okay? This started off as just a plain old block of cedar, okay? This is 1¾ by 1¾. If you go to Home Depot and you look it up, it's 2x2 cedar, okay? Now cedar, it's very, very light, very light. That's the reason why I chose cedar. And it smells like a hamster cage, okay? Cedar chips, it smells like cedar. So it's very super lightweight and it's not that strong, but the stronger woods are heavier woods and I don't like heavy. And if I'm going to carry this around my little marsupial, my little vaping man bag or vaping man purse that I carry around, I don't want it to be heavy and I don't want it to weigh down. Actually, the heaviest thing on here are these screws. That's it. Okay. So to get into the build, what I've got here, well, it's like I said, 1¾ by 1¾. Okay. And it says Big Lou's jig that I basically burnt on there with a soldering gun. I just had a soldering gun. Let it heat up and wrote my name in there. Just stabbed the wood little by little and I got Big Lou's jig. You can see the stab marks in the wood. Then I took a Burns-O-Matic torch, this thing. This is what I heat up my coils with. And I figured, you know what? What could be better than to take this color wood and instead of staining it with a chemical, I decided I was gonna naturally burn it to give it like this cool type of burnt look to it. I like it. I burnt it and then I sanded it down a little bit. Then after I was done sanding it down and burning it and all that other stuff, I took Rust-Oleum Clear, Ultra Cover, Gloss, Shiny, to make it shiny. I like the shiny look and plus it feels nice in my hands. Now, you don't have to use gloss. You could use matte, you could use satin, whatever you choose, whatever you want, okay? Now, how does this work as a coil jig? Well, it's very simple. I took a 1/4-inch drill bit, right? And what I did was, on the tip of the wood, I just cut a section right here, right? So I could remove this. When I remove this, you'll see there's two little shiny silver pieces in there. Those are finishing nails, okay? I put finishing nails in there. The reason why is because on this side, I have a magnet here. Where is it? I'm fucking camera, I'm all screwed up. Right there. There's an earth magnet there, and there's an earth magnet there. These are 3/8 of an inch holes, so I could fit. I just basically, you know, countersunk the magnets in there, okay? And then in the center, I did a 1/4 inch hole. Now you can see I've already got a crack over here. Well, that's my stupidity. When I installed this thing, I cracked it. This is just a prototype of my own design, and I'm sure I can graduate onto something like stainless or aluminum in the future. But today, we got wood. Plus, it's earthy, and it feels right, okay? Now, in this center hole right here, I keep my rods, okay? I keep 3 rods in here, 3 different sizes, okay? Those are my 3 rods. These are the coils that I usually make in size. You know, the big one, a medium one, and then a smaller one, okay? Now, when I'm done with them, I could just insert them in this hole and drop them in there. And then I could just take this and stick this on here, and that's it. It doesn't go anywhere. So I'm happy about that. That works. The magnets are super, super strong magnets, but I didn't put a lot of metal in this top cap. So it's enough for it to stick, but not to be like Mission Impossible to come off, okay? So I'm happy with that, okay? Secondly, on here on this side, you can see I have 4, but it was a mess up on that one over here, this hole. I did a big hole when I intended to do a small hole, so you can see I've got a smaller hole there, okay? Now, that's where I put my posts. Right, so basically I take out my posts once I remove the cover, and I could put a post here, which is a big one. I could put a post here, and I could put a post here. Okay, actually this one goes here, that's where that goes. Okay, that goes there, and this one goes here. Now obviously I'm not going to do a coil with all 3 of these in here. If I choose to do a small coil, I'll use this one. If I choose to do a large one, I'll do that one. And if I choose to do a medium sized one, I'll go here. Okay. So this is about 1/8. This is about 1/16. And this is 1/32. Okay. 1/32, 1/16, 1/8. Okay. Those are the drill bit sizes that I normally use. Now, if I'm going to do like a super nano coil or something, like I can use a paper clip, then I'll just use a paper clip. There's no need for me to use the jig. But I don't like doing those super nanos because they get so hot, and it makes my RDAs so, so, so hot that it burns the living hell out of my hand when I go to take the cap off and rejuice it. Plus, it makes the whole mod hot, and it also kills the living hell out of your batteries. So when I'm done with it, I put all the rods in the little hole right there, and then I put the cap back on. Now, that's that part. Then I decided to go an extra step. I put a 510 connect in there. And where did I get the 510 connect? Well, all it is just a simple adapter. It's a 510 adapter, okay? I used to use adapters all the time because my MVP version 1, it would, the connect never really would connect with my iClear 30s. It would drive me nuts. So I used to put the adapter on my MVP and then put the iClear 30 on that, and then I'd have a good solid connection. On occasion, I have that issue, if I can find the fucking thing, with my HANA mod. This thing sometimes does not make perfect connection with a lot of RDAs or a lot of clones. It may screw in, it may go flush, but then the pin doesn't make connection, and that drives me nuts. Therefore, I took the 510 adapter, I drilled a 3/8 hole, 3/8 drill bit I used right there, and drilled a 3/8 drill bit. I put some crazy glue in there, and I pushed the 510 connect down in there. So now I can, while I'm doing a build, or if I'm currently working on something, or whatever the case is, I take an RDA, I can screw it in here, it doesn't go anywhere, it's in there, and that's good. And so I can make my coils on one side, and I can have my RDA on another, okay? So that doesn't go anywhere, and I'm stoked about that, okay? So that's a plus. Plus, if I lay this flat on the table, you know, it'll be at eye level to me, my RDA. So that would be good. Well, not eye level, but it'll be higher than me looking all the way down. I can just, you know, I could work at a good level, at a good height, okay? Now, if you want to buy these parts, it's simple. The wood didn't cost me anything, really. I mean, it was like $2, something like that, $1.50. I bought these nuts. These are called T-nuts. And if you look at them, they have little hooks on the edges. I'm going to change my focus so you can see this. Let's see. Go into my focus mode. And there's my focus. Okay. So basically, you can see it's got these little hooks that stab themselves into the wood that'll hold them in place, okay? And this is a number 20 quarter-inch T-nut, okay? So if you go there, ask for a number 20 T-nut if you go to Home Depot or Lowe's, okay? So you get T-nuts. You get the cedar, right, which costs like next to nothing, and then you get the T-nuts. And then you gotta get quarter-inch screws, which I happen to have quarter-inch screws laying around from my old photo gear. This is my old photo gear. It's a screw that has from some old photo gear. But you could pick up butterfly nuts or bolts at Home Depot as well. And as long as they're quarter inch, they'll fit into those threads. Now I got three options of tying the wires down. 1, 2, and 3. So I can, you know, I could work at this hole and this hole and this hole without stretching a lot of canthal across a piece of wood. I could have just put one hole in the center and put one wire going here, one wire going there, one wire going there. You know, I could have done it any which way possible. Doesn't matter, you know. I could have done it another way. I could just utilize the center hole, put a post in it, and have a screw long enough that goes all the way through that holds the post in place and also acts as a wire hold. I could have done that. But I like the three. I like the three, the way I've got them going like that. You know, so we have the big hole in the center, we have a small hole over here, and then we have a medium-sized hole over there, you know? And that's about it, really. I mean, it doesn't take rocket science to do this. All I had was a piece of wood and some extra parts laying around, and then I made my own coil jig. So if anybody's feeling creative on the weekend, you want to create your own coil jig, feel free. There's no patent on this. I don't have a patent on this. I'm not going to patent. This is a piece of wood. This is just friendly advice I'm passing out from me to you, and that's about it. So I'm sure that once this video is released, there's going to be some retard out there that's going to put a claim to fame saying he made this. But you know what? I don't really care. So for my subscribers out there, if you want a coil jig and you want to make it yourself and you don't want to spend $40 on a piece of aluminum or like, you know, this that I bought that you could see, I use it as a hammer now. See all them scratches and everything in it? I use this as a hammer. This is temperamental. This gets on my nerves, this thing. Plus, you know, I don't know. I'm just irritated using this. This, believe it or not, this little puck is heavier than this piece of cedar. And this piece of cedar is gigantic. I mean, look at the difference in size. I mean, this is lighter than this. How can that be, you know? When I had this in my pocket, it was just, I have a mod in one pocket. This in another one. The other pocket, I have a spool of coil, you know, a spool of canthal. And then another pocket, I got a screwdriver. And then I moved up to like a backpack with all this stuff packed in there. I don't want to do all that. So you know what? This eliminates a lot of waste for me. And it's wood. And I love wood because wood is natural. It's real. It was once alive. And now here it is. I created a jig from it. So from me to you, YouTube, be creative. Invest $10 of your money. Go to Home Depot. Buy the parts you need. Not a big deal. Peace out. And talk to you later. Oh, and one last thing, the rods that I used for the coil jigs are these thin little rods. And these thin little rods are found in the hardware section as well. They're called music wire. Don't know why. That's just what they're called. So they're called music rods or music wire. You can get them in brass, you can get them in aluminum, or you can get them in steel. So from me to YouTube, peace out. Piece of chicken grease. Here's some more of them. Here's the brass and here's the aluminum. And these are the thicker ones, but the smaller ones are music wire. So that's about it. Music rods, music wire. Spent like $2 on them, whatever, $1.50. I don't even remember. But I went there, I spent like total $10. So peace out. Be creative. Vape on. Laters.